Today we will be discuss about electroconvulsive therapy. My moderator is Dr. Satish Rao. Introduction: Electroconvulsive therapy, formerly known as electroshock or electroplexy therapy, Selletti and Binney designed and built the first ECG device in Rome, Italy, in 1937. Definition: A medical procedure that involves the electrical induction of a series of generalized granular tissue under general anesthesia with the specific aim of bringing about therapeutic remission in patient suffering from episode of specific mental disorder such as major depression, mania and certain type of schizophrenia. Types of ECT. According to the technique, there is a direct ECT, modified ECT. According to the placement of electrode, there is a unilateral ECT and bilateral ECT. Methods. ECT can be given by direct and indirect method. In direct method, the patient is administered atropine sulfate subcutaneously 0.6 mg to 1 mg half an hour before the treatment or IV immediately before treatment, and minor tranquilizers like carnopose is also used if it is not necessary, and a grand mal seizure is induced in the patient by passing an electric current through the temporal lobe. Atropine prolongs the period of disorientation after seizure. About modified ECT, ECT is modified with the use of anesthesia, muscle relaxation and oxygenation. The use of anesthesia is necessary to allay the anxiety and achieve the maximum effect. It is used to modify the force of convulsion and to avoid complications like bone fractures. Modified ECT is also used for the patients who are recovering from heart deconditions. A short-acting barbiturates, methoxyl sodium or thiopental, and ultra-short-acting depolarizing agents, succinylcholine, are given intravenously. Observation of production of seizure. The production of grand mal seizure is necessary for direct and modified ECT. In direct ECT, tonic phase lasts for 10 seconds. The chronic phase lasts for 25 to 35 seconds. Then the patient goes to a relaxation phase. With the use of modified ECT, there is a mild premise or blepharo spasm is observed when the current is applied, and there is slow plantar flexion during the tonic phase, and there are fine movements of toes during the chronic phase. Regarding the number and frequency of ECT treatment, there is no clinical justification for a fixed number of treatment. Peak response is attained between 5 and 10 treatment for the patient with bipolar disorders, manic type schizoaffective disorder or catatonic schizophrenia. 20-25 treatments may be required for chronically ill schizophrenic patients. ECT does not prevent relapse, so maintenance the treatment should be with the drug or psychotherapy. The frequency of treatment can be reduced if the patient shows severe confusion state. With an extremely agitated, psychotic or suicidal patient, it may be useful to give the first few treatment on a daily basis. Again, the voltage, the standard voltage we used usually is 70 to 120 volts and duration is 0.7 to 1.5 seconds. Regarding the placement of electrodes, there is a bilateral. This is a standard form of ECT used most commonly, and each electrode is placed 2.5 cm to 4 cm above the midpoint on a line joining the tragus of the ear and the lateral canthus of the eye. Regarding the unilateral, here the electrodes are placed only on the side of the head, usually the non-dominant side, in the right-handed individual. Talk about the mode of action. Changes in the behavior due to ECT are attributed to an acute amnesic changes in the patient. Many patients who are getting ECT seem to forget what had been bothering them during the depressive episodes. Biological mechanism by which a therapeutic effect has been brought about by ECT includes neurochemical, neuroendocrine and neurophysiological. Neurochemical investigations have shown that the role of catecholaminergic effect is due to presynaptic and postsynaptic receptors, and the electrical changes action potentials arrives at the presynaptic terminal, and there will be a depolarization causes voltage gate calcium channel to open and result in a large influx of calcium, and this calcium causes the vesicle to fuse with the membrane and release the neurotransmitter, and the excitatory postsynaptic potential spread out over the dentals, and the chemical changes as precursor molecule and enzymes are transported down the axon from the cell body along the microtubules, followed by enzymes in the synaptic terminal convert the precursor molecule into active neurotransmitter, and the neurotransmitter is stored in the vesicle until released by the influence of calcium, and the released neurotransmitter bind with the receptor on the postsynaptic terminal and generate excitatory postsynaptic potential, and the reuptake of neurotransmitter limit the duration of signals and allow the cell to recycle the neurotransmitter. And this effort is also achieved due to seizure caused by ECT treatment. The neuropsychological effect due to ECT is achieved by due to cerebellar hypermetabolic state, and neuroendocrine changes have effect on depressive illness. Polypeptides from the hypothalamus changes the neuroendocrine activity, which affect the thalamocortical pathways. This is the widely accepted theoretical concept for the persistent behavior or therapeutic effect, that is changes in CNS due to repeated ECT seizures and not changes in the peripheral or visual component. Repeated seizures alter many brain functions like psychotic state, perception, recall, concentration, memory, orientation as well. Improvement in behavior is characterized by gain in weight, increased appetite, increased duration of sleep, increased libido, and increased interest in the environment. Then the indications. The most important indication is depression. In depression, there's a major severe depression, especially with suicidal with psychiatric features like delusion or hallucination, depressive stupor, puerperal depression, and postpartum psychosis in elderly patients, in first trimester pregnancy, schizoaffective depression, and second one is obsessional compulsion, and third one is schizophrenia. In schizophrenia, there's a catatonic schizophrenia and catatonic stupor, acute schizophrenic episode, schizophrenia with depression, mania that is treated of uncooperation behavior, bipolar mood disorder with rapid cycle, mania in first trimester of pregnancy, in postpartum psychosis, schizoaffective disorder, psychosis in first trimester of pregnancy. So the contraindication of ECT is increased intracranial pressure, including tumors, hematoma, subarachnoid hemorrhage, acute myocardial infarction, systemic hypertension, aneurysm, thromboflebitis, bleeding disorders, CVA, pneumonia, and tuberculosis, glaucoma, and retinal detachment. Side effects: death during ECTs are due to general anesthesia, headache and body ache, memory disturbance, confusion may occur in the postictal period, vomiting due to increased ICP, long bone fractures, dislocation of shoulder joint, arrhythmia. Complications are impairment of memory may vary from mild tendency to forget name to a severe confusion. To start with, the patient has a tendency to forget all type of events, but gradually limit the event just before the ECT treatment. This causes disturbance to the patients and his relative. They should be explained that these changes are temporary and the memory return fully within a week, few weeks to months. And medication used in ECTs are injection atropine, that is 0.6 mg to 1 mg, injection succinic column 1 mg per kg, injection sodium thiopental 3 to 5 mg per kg. A pre-treatment medication such as atropine sulfate or glycopyrrolate is administered IM 30 minutes before the treatment to decrease the secretion and counteract the effect of vagal stimulation induced by ECT. A short-acting anesthesia helps the patient should be unconscious when the ECT is given, and the muscle relaxation help to prevent the muscle contraction during seizure, that reduce the possibility of fracture or dislocated bone, and pure oxygen before and after treatment. Thank you.